Greetings, lords and ladies, this is Sir Talkslot. Want to thank you for joining me as we play Super Mario Galaxy. In the last episode, we technically beat the game. I know, right? If you guys haven't seen that video, it was an awesome video. I put a lot of effort into it, and I hope you guys... And I just want you guys to see it so badly, if you haven't seen it already. So, in the end of the last video, I was describing the Purple Comet a little bit. So basically, if you guys didn't see that video, what the Purple Comet essentially is, it's basically a 100 coin challenge. You have to collect 100 of these purple coins. But there are a few little cryptic factors. For example, these coins don't heal your health. So, and in purple coin missions, normal coins are actually very rare for some reason. I don't know why it is, but they're just pretty rare. So getting hit by an enemy or getting damaged of some sort is a lot more devastating than you would think it would be. Don't worry, we're not going to be going to that spear in the middle. So once you touch down here, you'll already notice there's a whole bunch of these little purple coin things right here. So the goal is always to collect 100. Now sometimes there'll be like 150 where you have to collect, you just have to collect 100 of them. You don't have to collect all 150. And that's cool and all because, you know, it gives you opportunity to make a little bit of mistakes because obviously you're probably not going to collect them all, you know. You need like super skill for that. So this purple coin mission's actually really easy because all the coins are laid out in a straight line. Now I get it, but, you know, to show you how the purple coins work and all, but it's still pretty easy. And there we go, we're going to be collecting some more coins in midair. They're just out for the grabbing. And then there's some more of these purple coins right here on this egg planet. Probably 10 more, maybe 15. Yeah, okay, 10 more. And then we blast off once again. We're going to be collecting some more coins. And then, yeah, we don't have any coins there. So now we're going to be taking all the bonus routes because those actually have some purple coins as well. In case you guys were wondering. So, So, the rest of the purple coins are on the additional routes. We just gotta, you know, do those additional little stars right there. And we should get them, at least eventually. So, there we go. And now we're gonna be collecting some more coins. And then the last purple coins will be in some alternate route. They'll be all probably off that star, if I had to guess. There we go, the launch star is right there, and then it'll take us to this little launch star right here, and you blast through that, and then where are the purple coins? That's where I'm, okay, there they are. It's really hard to see because they're kind of far away. So there we go, we crash landed on, the egg planet, or is this not the egg planet? I think this may be the eggplant. Okay, yeah, sorry. I didn't really know. So, now we are blasting back towards the main planet, this area. And that is where the power star is going to be revealed at. There it is over there. It's shining bright. And it just wants us to collect it. Because it knows we put a lot of effort into these purple coins. Or into this purple coin challenge. So, these purple coin challenges can actually take a while. Because they can simply be pretty tricky, like if you die, then you have to restart the entire mission because it's a comet. And there are some purple coin missions that are so tedious to get, like some of them can take like 15 minutes for one mission. I'm not even joking. That's how long they can be. But I guess they do have to be that long, you know what I mean? They have to supply a lot of extra content because the purple comets, I mean, they're basically extra content. You don't have to do them. But they still take a while. So now if we look here, look at how many comets are available to us. There are literally 5 purple comets. I'm not even joking. That's a lot of purple coins. Okay, if we're gonna do one, I guess we'll do, okay. There are a few purple coin challenges that are really time consuming. That one's time consuming. That one, I don't know what that one is. I guess I'll do the Garden Galaxy first. I mean, I think it's one of those more quicker ones, but at the same time, it It's a bit more relaxed. I mean, it does have a time limit, but still really like a fun mission and all. And let's just go to it right now. So, as with the other comets, I think it'll shadow out every single other comet in the area. And that's perfectly okay because, I mean, it does deserve a lot of attention. I mean, what do you expect? It's a purple. It's a purple. It's a comet. You know what I mean? It's better than all those other levels. Forget them. We just need these purple comets. So, do you remember that puzzle cube that was early in the galaxy where we had chased down that rabbit? Well, the point of this mission is to collect a whole bunch of purple coins in this. Now, remember what I was saying earlier, or I might have said this in the last video, about how there's either 150 of them or there's just 100? This is one of those levels where there's actually 150. So if that makes you feel a little bit better, then appreciate that. So you get 2 minutes and 30 seconds, which is, you know, not a bad time limit or anything. It can just be a little tricky at times. So the majority of coins are, I don't think, too bad to get. Yeah, see, the sign will tell you collect 100 of the 250 coins. And we're making good time right now. There is a lot of coins to collect, but that's perfectly okay because we have a good amount of time to explore. Whenever I do these time missions, I always think I have, like, no time to complete them, and I just get so scared, and then I just try to do it as fast as I can. And while we don't have a lot of time to complete them, it's weird because I think we actually do have more time than I make it out to be. You know, I'm thinking it's like we have, like, 30 seconds to complete this one when we actually have, like 2 minutes or something like that. So basically there's a lot of purple coins here. Who scattered all these here? You know, then again, who scattered the purple coins across all of these galaxies? Oh my gosh, Gary. Who scattered them across this entire galaxy? You know, did someone just trip up on a delivering job in one of the Mario or Luigi RPG games? You know, is it that infamous delivery toad in Mario Paper Jam? He was basically a toad who dropped a whole bunch of mushrooms. Is it him? Is he back? Is he the bad guy in this game? Is he invaded Super Mario Galaxy? All these questions will be answered in due time. So, yep, there we go. There's a whole bunch of these little purple points. Oh, okay, we gotta hurry up. So there we go, we only have like 18. We gotta slow trot a little bit simply because these purple coins are a little tricky spots to get. Because they're on these, well, somewhat tall walls. And there is that rabbit hole in the middle, in case you guys are wondering. So if you need to make quick travel, you can just head into that. There we go, we've almost got this in the bag. And okay, this part's a nightmare right here, because look at the platforming you're given. And yep, there we go, we got the power star. Has the time limit stopped? That'll be the question. Okay, it has not stopped. We have got to find where the power star is. Where's the... Okay, there it is. Yes, guys, there's the power star. We're going to die if we're just wasting time here. Haha. So, yes, we've gotten the power star. I really do wonder if it's possible to collect 150 coins on a 100 purple coin mission. Because I don't think they give you enough time to do that. But if someone really was skilled enough to do that, I would be in awe. So, purple coins on the puzzle cube, simple mission, pretty easy and all. I mean, okay, it did have a pretty strict time limit, but we managed to do it pretty well. No casualties or anything, because, I mean, Mario doesn't like casualties nowadays, does he? So, if you were noticing from some earlier encounters how there's, like, a second comet, and you're like, wait, what is that for? That's a why hasn't it appeared yet? Well, this is the reason why. Because of these comets. Okay, from what I can see, there's a purple star over that room. Is that the fountain? Is that what that's supposed to be? I can't really tell. It looks like the fountain. And if there is something in the fountain, then I'll do it. But I'm just curious. Okay, what is in here? Thankfully, all of the purple coin comets come at you in this whole big blast. So you can easily do a whole lot of them at once. So as you can see, there is purple coin comets in both of these galaxies. Or at least I think they are. Maybe they're comets from other things, but at least they look like purple coin ones. So, let's make our way back to the drawing board, and I mean that quite literally because there is actually, you know, the main board for where you can see all your star progress. And we're gonna see where the remaining purple, well, stars are. Because that is always awesome nowadays, isn't it? To see where purple coins are. So, I think you might have missed one. If I find it, I'll write you a letter. I'm keeping my eyes peeled on you, Luigi. You're suspicious. But There we go. Now we can head for the main roof. And where do we have to go? Okay, look at that. There is another one in the terrace. That is actually the only one available, in fact. I guess they just gave us all of the innovation at once, and then they're like, nah, just do it one at a time. Forget all that innovation. So anyway, what comet do we have to do? We have to do the Honey Hive Galaxy. And that is pretty sweet, because this galaxy is awesome, as you know. And let us see what it is. I don't remember if this one's timed or not. I think it is timed, but you only have to collect the gun. You have to collect strictly 100 coins. So basically, the double duo that makes it nasty. Maybe this one isn't timed. I don't know. Maybe this one doesn't look like it may be timed. The coins are too spread out, I think, to be timed. So, okay, let's see what these coins. They're suspicious, I tell you. So, Mario's trotting through the water right here. And then he's got some of these right here. And the trickiest thing about purple coins is that they're hidden in some of the most maybe annoying spots in some of video game history. I'm not even joking. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to look at this very tiny ledge right here and collect one. I know. They're that tricky. I'm not even joking. They're that tricky. No, I don't mean that like in their a way that they're easy. They're actually really are tricky. And if you thought that was bad, there are galaxies much later in the game that are way worse. So I'm trying to use the infinite. I'm trying to use the slope glitch if I can, because I know it's just a game mechanic flaw, but it is actually pretty useful in some levels. There we go. We're making our way up there. No. Okay. There we go. There we go. We gotta do it a little slow by slow, but we're making our way up there. Oh, dang. Mario's like at a side angle or something, so it's weird for him. Forget it. I'll just go down the hill if I want to get that purple coin. Or maybe I could just jump to it. That'd be... Okay, guess not. Mario, you do not have the jumping skills like your brother Luigi. He has much better jumping skills. So this is another one of those really weird purple coins that's just in one of those spots where you're like, what? Are the developers trying to troll me? It's just in one of those spots. So, yep, activated the vine and all. But we're going to be going back here and seeing what's back here. More purple coins. I need those purple coins. I want them. I want them desperately. So, a few of them up this area. And be sure not to miss any right here. Any up this tree. That'll be curious to see if there are any up this tree. Okay. There are not. Oh yeah. I forgot this game doesn't take fall damage, so I'm used to that from like Super Mario 64. So in this swing right here, look at that. There's a normal coin in a purple coin treasure. I know, it's legendary. I know, it's legendary. It deserves the music. So, these coins are pretty straightforward right here. Okay. If Mario's grandpa didn't go for that, I don't know what to go for. Waterfall. Okay, you're not gonna give me a waterfall? You're not gonna give me that coin? Well, that's fine, waterfall. I can deal with it. So, wait, gotta... Okay, that looks really weird for Mario. He was just, like, standing in nowhere. So, whole bunch of these little breakable platforms right here. Kind of easy to deal with, though. And there's this really huge one. Yeah. Okay, that was really satisfying. So, I think there's some purple coins across. Okay, maybe there are not. Maybe there are not. This prior plant guy right here. Now these guys are gonna try and suck on Mario's essence, but we're gonna suck him back with a spin. And Mario just did a super long jump or something like that. Now, there is no bee mushroom, so you do have to use some classic wall skills in order to make it across this area. And you may be wondering, hey, why are there purple coins on that side? That doesn't seem like any fair. Well, what you have to do is you have to enter into this pipe, and then it'll take you to this area. I think you have to... Okay, the pipe is that way. Wait, can we go... Wait, how do we get up there? I'll figure it out eventually. I'm sure the game will make it. If they purposely wanted me to use the slope glitch on that, I don't know what I'd do. I'd be like, "Oh, game launch," and the game would be like, "Maybe the pipe transports me to the top or something like that." Well, anyway, there is a one-up mushroom. It's pretty difficult not to avoid simply because there's a purple coin right behind it. You know what I mean? Why wouldn't you collect the one-up mushroom unless you do not want Mario to have any more mushrooms. I guess Mario doesn't need any more mushrooms nowadays, does he? I mean, come on, Mario's already addicted to them. He does not need any more in his diet. So maybe this pipe will transport me to the top of the hill, if it's nice. No, it had to be evil. Okay, never mind. Okay, so you can jump from across here. I guess we'll go to this vine section now. You know, I'll go to the other side of the galaxy. See, that jump right there is really scary right there. The one that goes in between the vines. Because if you spin while doing it, you're gonna ruin your chance for a good jump. So, look at that. Hardcore, expertly skilled, and pulled off. And then, there's this coin right here. I really don't want to lose my vine progress. I'm going to try to make it. Darn it, Mario. Why, Mario? Oh, jeez. Jeez, that scared me. Why? No! The stupid boulder. Since when do boulders do that? That boulder. I'm probably just gonna skip right to the. I'm gonna recollect the coins I just did, guys, and hopefully not get killed by that stinking boulder. See you guys then. I mean, seriously, that gravity was weird. Well, anyway, see you guys then. Welcome back, guys. We are back at this area, and I don't quite have 48 coins, but we have 41, and I think that's close enough. You know what I mean? It got them out good. So, I made sure to collect all the coins, or at least collect most of the coins that we already went to, just so you guys could see any of the new ones. So, these piranha plants over here will try to be annoying, but thankfully they do not do it very successfully. And ground pound. Now we're gonna swing over to the section. I never shake the Wii Remote when it comes to that jump. I just get so scared. I mean, I know I already described why, but, like, I will still never shake the Wii Remote when it comes to that section. I don't know why I just... So, okay, there's those three coins. Come on. Okay, we're fine. Is Mario gonna make it up there? Maybe from this backwards perspective, Mario will have a better chance of doing it. Camera, don't quit on me now. Don't quit on me now. I'm finally doing really good. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh, no. Whoa. Oh, come on. Okay. Forget it. Darn it, I had the glitch. I had it so- Oh, no! You're not gonna knock me off again, you little boulder. You're not. Sorry about that. Oh my gosh, I had that glitch so well. It was so close. But that's fine. I guess we can just collect these art coins. You know, we just take the normal route. Yeah, it's probably gonna be taking the normal route anyway. What a little glitch could do. So, there's a whole bunch of these little, well, okay, there's some acronyms here. Be careful when you're going across this edge area. I mean, not like these. I mean, these are kind of close to the edge, but they're really not that bad. Yeah, there we go. And then, see, it spells out another Mario. Well, I guess that's the one from earlier. And all goes pretty well until you reach these coins. And as you can see, they're on the very edge of a fallable platform. Highly recommended. You know what I bet this game is teaching? I bet it's teaching people to just walk on very skinny platforms and think like they're safe. I'm just saying, it's just a hidden strategy thing. So, you can still access this bridge over here, and it will lead you to the top section of this galaxy. But we are going to be collecting a few more purple coins before that happens. Now, I don't think we've gotten all the purple coins in this bottom section yet. Yeah, Lulette, look at that. Wow. That's just mean right here, these two. And look at that. You can really die there if you're not careful. And there's also those three little purple coins right here. Because as if they didn't want to emphasize the point that a lot of them were up here. But there is this little bridge right here. And it'll probably lead to something if I fell off there. I don't know what I'd do. But ground pound the switch and then it'll create this little... I mean, not really like wall jumping section. Well, I mean, I guess it is kind of a little area to test some of your wall jumping skills. I mean, come on. Keep in mind this is the second galaxy besides the real galaxy in the game. You really think they're gonna go tremendously hard on you? I mean, I get that you've done other galaxies in the game up to this point, but it's just the first galaxy in the game. I mean, second galaxy in the game. Come on. So that purple coin is just... it's just evil. I mean, it's not really... You know, what's funny is that the easier missions are actually the purple coins that require you to do death-like stuff. And whoa, that was really too close for comfort. That was way too close. And yeah, oh, you've got to be kidding me. They have another one that's like that? Oh, okay, at least it's not into instant death, but whoa. Still, that's just annoying. It's even there. There we go, got it. And there are some purple coins down there. We're going to be collecting those in just a minute. But for now, you can wall jump up this section and get a few purple points there. Now, let's see. The waterfall will lead down here. And look at that. What do we find here? Purple coins. Wow. Anyway, what I think you actually have to do here to get... And I think the normal route down this section is something to do with the slide. I'm not exactly sure, but I think it's something. Okay, I made it up there, at least. Okay, is there... I just see a... Hey, there is one up here. Wait, where do you have to... Wait, how do you get up there, then, if it's... I'm not really... Maybe you just have to fall from here or something. Or maybe this is the wrong route, I don't know. I don't know, this section's kind of weird. Maybe you just have to go across the wall and then fall into this waterfall section or something. Something really weird like that. So, yep, made it. And then a few more purple points in this section. We are almost at 100. As you can see, these missions are very time-consuming. And, yep, got it. Now this little bug guy's here. He's like, well, I'm gonna end him. And then we do not have that many purple coins left, guys. I don't really know which ones we do have left to collect, but the ones we do must be pretty small. I know we have the ones that are on the slide in the weird... Okay, wait. Mario, go back. Yeah, we're not going to be going across there yet. I know where some of them are, but I'm not really sure where the others are, so... Oh, okay, there's one back there. Of course it had to be one of those devious ones. I mean, why wouldn't it be devious? And I mean, if anything those purple coins are, they are devious. There's like these two purple coins in one galaxy. It's the flame burn, or whatever, the frost galaxy. You know, guys, what I'm talking about. The one in world, like, four or something. In that galaxy, it is so annoying the work they have to put you through. You have to, like, do this... There's two purple coins. You have to make it all the way up into that secret mountain area, if you guys remember. And you have to jump off the edge onto these two very small slopes. I know, it is literally that annoying. So, I don't really know how to get on top of this section without maybe cheating the game a bit or something. Does this game want you to use the infinite thing? Is that what they... The slope does seem pretty easy to do it on. Oh my... Okay, Mario's at a sideways angle. That's not really a good thing. Okay, he's fixing himself again. If I look at the top, maybe there's something there. Do I have to, like... Did people have to, like, unscrew the gate or something? Like... What is up here that... I'm gonna be able to... Whoa. Okay, jeez Louise. Okay, there's some way to make it up there. I just don't know it. I just don't know the way, because it's just really... I gotta use my mind on this. It's made up. Do we have to, like, jump through the holes or something? That would seem convenient. Oh, curses. Mario? You gonna work with me? No, you're not gonna work with me. I just don't know where to go. And I've played this game a lot of times. Hey. Well, there's gotta be some strategy around here. I'm gonna skip ahead, guys, until I find where the rest, or at least where the rest of these guys. Like, I'm not gonna collect these purple coins, but I'm gonna find where they are. See you guys then again. Oh my gosh. Hopefully. Okay, guys, we are back. I collected a few coins. So actually what you have to do is you remember that section that's above there. Darn, that's a terrible camera view. But you remember that section that was slightly above, well, the waterfall area where you get it to the very top and there's two pillars which you wall jump between. You have to fall behind it and then you'll see there's these two platforms right here. One of them's higher. The camera will adjust to let you see them, but you have to get in the perfect position. And you have to fall right on top of them. I also got one of the coins because I forgot to look behind that area in the very beginning, the level behind the fence. So that's where that coin was, if you guys were curious. We're going to be collecting these final three. And let me guess, they're going to appear. Yep, they had appeared in the very exact opposite spot. I knew it. I told you guys. So now we're going to be making our way all the way back here. You actually can die with 100 coins. I'm not even joking. You can actually die with 100 coins. So you want to be very careful if you're making your way back to the star. I'm just so nervous that, like, the boulder's gonna hit me or something. And then I'll rage quit or something. Yep. And look at that. We are clear for the star. Yep. Got it. That's skills, baby. So that is the purple coin challenge of the Honey Hive Galaxy. I know. Oh, look at that. We're going back to the main Comet Observatory area. Maybe Rosalina has something to say to us. Well, I mean, get through this outro and all. Increase your starbit count. And then, oh, look at that. It's this guy. I have a letter from Luigi. Bro, I got a star, but now I can't get back. This picture shows where I am. Help me. Where is that place? It looks familiar, but then again, let me give you this picture so you won't forget where Luigi is. To view a picture, press minus or plus to access the pause screen, then use the letter icon to check the picture. So guys, you actually do have to talk to Luigi, and then you'll activate him, and then he'll get you power stars. But the trick is, you have to find him and once he gets them, so it's basically still a power star mission. So I'm getting the interview here, guys. Thank you for watching. Please leave a like and be sure to subscribe. I truly appreciate it. Those purple coin challenges, they're really cool. I like the addition they add to the game. They're sometimes nuisances, but they added a whole new level of gameplay. Fare thee well.